At once I was in the Spirit, and there before me was a throne in heaven with someone sitting on it. And the one who sat there had the appearance of jasper and ruby, a rainbow that shone like an emerald encircled the throne. Surrounding the throne were 24 other thrones, and seated on them were 24 elders. They were dressed in white and had crowns of gold on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning, rumbles, and peals of thunder. In front of the throne, seven lamps were blazing. In the center, around the throne, were four living creatures, and they were covered with eyes in front and in back. Day and night, they never stopped saying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." Whenever the living creatures give glory, honor, and thanks to Him who sits on the throne and who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before Him who sits on the throne and worship Him who lives forever and ever. They lay their crowns before the throne and say, "You are worthy, our Lord and our God, to receive glory and honor and power, for You created all things, and by Your will they were created and have their being."
Say Jesus our anchor. Yeah. We've been talking a lot about anchors.
Yes, well.
Or I may even name it anchored in Jesus, the solid rock.
Mm-hmm. My mercy, Lord. My mercy.
And the Bible text Reverend Williams read earlier too for us. And it says, so, Isaiah 28:16. So, this is what the sovereign Lord says. See, I lay a stone in Zion, a tested stone, a precious cornerstone for a sure foundation. The one who relies on it will never be stricken with panic. So in other words, if you anchored in the Lord, you don't have to panic about nothing. Mm-hmm. You don't have to worry about nothing. Mm-hmm. You know what I did this morning? I brought my own anchor.
All right.
So that I can anchor the Lord to me while I do this message today. And I'm going to leave you, Brother Earl, to come up here and kind of help me get anchored or stay anchored. Because you know what? It doesn't matter if I'm anchored and I'm not helping somebody.
Amen.
So, Brother Earl, I want you to just hold on to this thing. Hold on that side.
Yes.
Reverend Williams, hold on this side.
Yeah.
I'm anchored.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm ready.
Hallelujah.
I'm ready for everything that's out here now. You see, you wonder what I'm doing with this. I'm not crazy. I'm just trying to show you that you can relax for a minute. That today is Missionary Emphasis Day all over CNE Zion. And here at ISOM, we are celebrating. This is not a Sunday service program. This is a celebration.
Yes,
we are celebrating Missionary Emphasis Day.
Yes, Lord.
And you see, we're wearing our blue and our white. The missionary colors are white with a touch of blue, missionaries, a touch of blue. But on today, the fifth Sunday, we wear our royal blue. Chosen royalty in us. We're royalty missionaries.
Yes.
We wear our royal blue hat. So now the scripture talks about being an anchor. In scripture, an anchor is a metaphor to represent God and faith, that which gives us hope during trials and in the storm of life. So we've got hope. We've got hope in Jesus.
Yeah.
Hebrews 6:16-20 tells us that it is our hope in Christ that is the anchor for our soul.
Yeah.
It's our confidence that God is with us and that He will carry us through whatever our trials are.
Yeah.
God's got me. I can't go nowhere because He got me.
My
I'm anchored in Him.
Yeah.
It's the crazy thing is that many of us are anchors which can hold people who haven't come to Christ yet. They don't know Him. And when we're an anchor, we can help to anchor them until they get to the point where they can anchor themselves.
Yes, yes.
Where they can encounter Christ for themselves.
Yes.
Brother Earl over here, he was going through some stuff.
Yes, Lord.
And he was ready to let go. But he didn't let go. You know why? People like you, missionaries, people like you, Reverend Williams, people like you, Reverend Harris, Dr. Harris, and Sister Nancy over here, and Brother over here, are anchored in Jesus.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so you hold them up.
Yes.
Yes.
You hold them up so that they don't have to fall.
Yes, Lord.
This rope represents an anchor.
Yes.
When we're in the storm of our lives,
yes,
and we're connected to Jesus,
yes,
that anchor, God, Jesus, will steady us.
Yes. Yes.
It doesn't matter, yes, how much he wants.
My body.
God steadies us.
Yes.
So when God is steadying us, ain't none of us gonna fall.
Right.
Yeah. None of us.
Mama.
None of us, yes, is going down.
Yes.
You know why none of us is going down?
Yes.
None of us is going down because we got something stronger. Stronger than any of us.
Yes, Lord.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
His,
yes,
name is Jesus.
Jesus.
And we need to be an anchor for our children,
yes, Lord,
our families,
yes,
our,
Lord,
neighbors,
yes,
our,
Lord,
churches.
Yes.
We need to hold tight to our babies, yes, our youths, yes, our young adults,
yes,
our pastors. They might be our pastors, but they need support just like you do.
Yes,
if you,
Lord,
see your pastor is going through something,
yeah,
they're human too.
Yeah.
They go through stuff.
Yeah.
Missionaries, don't fight against them. Hold on to them.
Yes,
if you anchored in the Lord, you need to hold on,
oh,
so that none of you will fall.
Yes, Lord.
So, you know, we've got little Rossi T. Hollises and Mary E. Colemans in our congregation, and we need to teach them. We need to teach them how to become anchored in Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Because they can't do it for themselves. So we have to talk about Jesus to them. We have to teach them how to talk. We have to teach them how to pray.
Yes,
we have,
Lord,
to teach them how to come to Sunday school and learn and study the Word of God. We have to teach them how to give and not just ask for stuff all,
yeah,
the time.
Yes.
The Word tells us,
mm-hmm,
it is better to give than to receive.
Mm-hmm.
So missionaries, and really truth is, I'm not just talking to missionaries today. I'm talking to all of God's children.
Yes.
We all need to be anchored to the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And so my question is to you today, what would happen if we would let our babies or any of our children go out into the sea of life,
mm-hmm,
and we didn't show them how to become anchored,
yes,
in Jesus?
Mama.
What would happen to them?
Lord.
Some of us wouldn't be here,
yes,
because they come and knock us out,
yes,
because they didn't know any better. We've got to teach them. When we make Jesus our anchor, we become empowered by His Spirit.
Yes.
Philippians 4:13 tells us we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. That is my favorite scripture, one of my favorite scriptures. And yes, I can. I can do all things. Because guess what? I'm not going to fall because I'm anchored.
Mm.
Ah! I am anchored.
Yeah.
And we need to teach each other how to become anchored.
Yes.
And it's not hard.
Yes.
It's not hard. But my prayer today is for each of us to be anchored in the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We can use our missionary hands as our daily guide.
Yes, Lord.
Missionary hands say, pray, study, talk, work, and give. Yes, give.
Uh-huh.
None of us like conference play, but give. Why? Because that's what the Word of God says. Give. We give it to God to do His work, not to the pastor, not to the bishop. We give it to help do what the Lord wants us to do. And we can accomplish this if we spend more time in the Bible. The Bible, the Word of God. The word Bible spells B-I-B-L-E. When you break it down, it means basic instruction before leaving earth. So in other words, He's giving you everything that you need in the Bible so that you can become anchored, and that you may continue to be anchored, and that you may continue to bless each other. I thank you, Isom, for inviting me. I pray that this word will be a blessing to somebody. whether it's out there in virtual world or here today. I thank you and I thank God for this opportunity.
All right.
I bless you all.
Amen.